Thanks for joining me to talk about clinical trials with regard to malignant brain tumors. Clinical trials, of course, a source of hope for people with this dire diagnosis. When should someone think about a clinical trial?
Well, thank you for having me. It's a very important question that you just asked. Clinical trials often come into play when folks have completed what's considered standard of care, meaning they've often had surgery, completed additional treatments, often in the form of chemotherapy and or radiation therapy, and unfortunately it appears that the tumor may be coming back. Once standard of care has been completed, then we can think about more experimental options, i.e. clinical trials, which are designed to develop new therapies, new treatments, with the hope of being able to better combat the various brain tumors that we take care of.
How can someone find out about what range of clinical trials are available?
That often is one of the challenges when dealing with clinical trials. The biggest key to this is to maintain constant dialogue at the time of diagnosis and throughout care with one's treating oncology team members, radiation oncology, medical oncology, as well as surgeons, to see what options might be available if they were to arise. In addition, there's a publicly available database online that lists all the clinical trials available in the United States currently. That's clinicaltrials.gov, G-O-V, and it's a fairly easy to navigate website that is mandated by the U.S. government to list all clinical trials for the treatment of malignant brain tumors as well as other diseases, and certainly something that's open to the public as well.
What are the risks that are involved in participating in a clinical trial? And if you were going to help a patient make that decision, how would you weigh the risks and benefits?
Another very important question. The first thing to understand is that really the vast majority of studies that have looked at this have shown that patients with malignant brain tumors or other types of cancer that participate in clinical trials, they do better than counterparts who don't. So that's the first thing to understand, is that clinical trials in general, even though we're testing experimental therapies, help patients live longer and do better. Part of that is because they get more intense care, they're more closely monitored, and this eventually helps patients. So that's the first thing to understand. In terms of the risks of clinical trials, it really depends on what type of trial we're talking about. Some trials have very minimal risks, things like fatigue or potential rash, to very serious complications that can occur depending on the type of treatment that's being employed. And when I counsel my patients about this, we have a very granular discussion about what are the different options and go through each trial in detailed and systematic fashion to say these are the potential benefits, these are the potential risks, and we learn as we go along with these clinical trials because they're all still in their infancy in terms of the development.
Help me to understand how tumor genetics could be important in treatment options.
So tumor genetics is basically our understanding of why these cells that were previously normal became abnormal and cancerous or tumorous. And the goal is to identify, using understanding of these changes, an Achilles heel, i.e. a weakness in the tumor cell that may not be present in the normal cell. By understanding the tumor genetics, we hope to be able to develop treatments or employ treatments that attack the Achilles heel of that particular cancer or tumor that the individual is going through.
I know there's an awful lot of research going on out there, but what would you consider to be the cutting edge of research in clinical trials for malignant brain tumors right now?
Well, there's a tremendous avalanche of incredible advances. If I were to have to pick one treatment option that's increasingly common and in the clinical trial realm, would be immunotherapy. That is, using one's own immune system to attack tumor cells. There's a number of very, very exciting protocols that do this in a multitude of ways. Vaccine treatments, using viruses to ramp up the immune system, using drugs to allow the immune cells to target tumor cells. And this has been a treatment that's really gained a lot of attention because it's worked in a number of other non-brain tumor cancer types like lung cancer, melanoma, and others, and we're very, very hopeful to see such dramatic results when employed in brain tumors as well.
Sounds to me like you're pretty optimistic about the outlook.
Absolutely. Never before have there been this many options and this many good options for our individuals with malignant brain tumors. And while it is a very challenging diagnosis to hear, it is certainly one that's filled with more hope now than ever before.
Great news. Thanks so much.
Thank you for having me.